Welcome to 10 Dates. You're here to watch me make a fool of myself as I go speed dating with some randos in this wonderful game. This game is the sequel to 5 Dates, which I just played the other day. So I got my White Claw and let's just hop right into it, I guess. I think we're good to go. Okay, so I can be Misha, which is a girl, or I could be Ryan, who's a guy. I guess let's play as Misha. First, you need to be found. Misha, 27, she's 5'2", and from London. Okay. Oh, okay, so profile picture. Hey, Misha, we are going with this. Finance, creative, healthcare, or other. Let's do healthcare. Okay, and we get 3 interests again. So let's go spirituality, food and drink, and charity. I don't know. Her star sign. Her star sign will be Sagittarius. Let's see. All right, incoming call from Ryan.
Ah, oh, there was me having a good day.
Well, it's just become great. You're welcome.
What's happening?
I just got back from work an hour ago.
Same.
I made myself some food.
Same.
And I've just got off the phone with my landlord.
Oh, not same.
Yeah, I missed a payment, but it's fine. I've paid it now and it's settled anyway.
Mm. Anyway, I've got some news.
Okay.
I joined a dating app.
Have you? Well, I mean, they are inevitable.
I was expecting more shit from you.
Well, what's the saying? They have people in glass houses can't throw stones.
No way, you too! Matches?
Yes, a lot. Huh. No, 0.
But don't apps like help out new users with
Misha,
like, likes and...
you're not helping!
You know, they really try and help you get people to like you because you're new.
Misha, I still have 0, even with whatever you just said. There's still 0. What about you?
Hey, the grass isn't always greener. I've got like... 80 likes.
80.
But like once you filter out like the bad profiles and the nude pics and the meh ones, it's all just a bit quiet.
Are your standards a little bit high?
No.
No.
Anyway.
That's what it's like.
I have a new initiative in the works.
What's that? You're going to kidnap someone?
I've signed up for speed dating tonight.
Okay. Why are you telling me this?
Because I'm booking it and like, do you want to have a drink before?
Could you just say
heck
less?
Yeah.
It'd be great if you just stopped speaking about 30 seconds ago.
See you there. Bye.
Bye.
Because there's no substitute for meeting someone face to face. Like you can see their physicality, feel their vibe.
Yes, but what if there is no vibe? What do you do then? If you're online, you can log off, you can make it an excuse, you can just be gone. My internet connection was crap. Mm. What do you do here?
Welcome everyone to Speed Dating. My name's Derek, I'm your host. We're gonna be beginning very shortly, so gentlemen, if you could make your way to your table numbers.
You are so cynical. This is where you're gonna find that genuine connection you keep banging on about.
Why are you smiling at me like that?
They're so cute together.
Why are you smiling at me like that?
No, I'm not smiling, you're like everything.
Misha?
She did something.
There is a small possibility I might have signed us both up.
Oh.
I'm not doing it.
You are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'll just leave.
Oh, come on.
No.
Look, at least it's going to be a good story.
It is not going to be a good story. I'm just going to get humiliated. You've been preparing for this. I'm not doing it.
It's a great story. Oh, he's browsing. He's browsing the shop floor.
How does it work?
Sorry, what?
Don't make me repeat myself.
Okay, so the women stay at the table, the men, you, rotate around them.
I'm a man now.
So you go to different tables and you speak to girls.
What do I say?
Whatever you like, but you have 5 minutes, okay?
Okay.
And halfway through the date, that dude over there will give us a warning. And then he'll also tell us when there's 1 minute left to wrap it up. So essentially, you've got to use your time wisely, which I know you're not good at.
No, hence why I don't want to do it.
Exactly.
We're going to start with the gentleman by your first allotted table numbers. And good luck. Have fun.
He's cute.
You're sitting in my first date seat, so I need you to jog on. Go well, lad. Cheers.
Lucas, head in the cloud.
Oh, hey.
Can I?
Yeah, of course.
Thank you. Have you been waiting long?
No, I've been waiting my whole life for this.
Sorry. I've only just finished work, you see, so it takes me a minute to recalibrate.
I get that. For my out-of-hours time, I volunteer at a charity shop. I started doing it at school and just never really stopped.
Oh, that's really good. That's amazing.
Do you do anything like that?
Yeah. I mean, when I get the free time to, yeah, I will give out as much as I can. I mean, not in person like you. Basically, I'll offer my coding expertise and help charities, you know, update their websites.
That's really cool.
I am a freelance computer engineer. That's what I do. And because of that, my work hours are just all over the place.
What's your living situation? Do you have any flatmates?
I actually live on my own, which, to be honest, I love. Antisocial, though. I don't know if you found this, but as you get older, there's just harder and smaller avenues of making friends because everyone's already found their clique, you know? So I suppose things like this are amazing for that.
If you don't mind me asking, how do you afford to live on your own?
Something I was working on just did well, so. And I decided, yeah, I'm going to get myself a place. I deserve it. And the rest is history. What about you? Do you prefer to live on your own or with people?
I've tried both. I worked away for a bit and they put me up.
Oh, that's...
I'm going to go
with
Cher.
Really good way of experiencing being on your own, I suppose.
It's lovely getting home to a warm house with people in it. Mm-hmm. I think it's quite a special time in life.
What is?
Oh, living with friends. Doesn't last forever.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, like having roommates.
For me, again, I definitely love being alone, but it's great that you've experienced that.
So if you like living on your own, does that mean you wouldn't want to live with a partner?
No, I'd definitely live with someone, especially if it was someone, you know, that really meant something to me. I think what I need is just my own space to be able to work and focus. That's it.
That's healthy. The last couple of years have been tough, but I'm grateful that we went through it when we had video calling.
Exactly, I mean, and that wouldn't have been possible without technology.
It's taking over the world.
So are you aware of the synchronicity then? That's when AI will eventually surpass mankind. You know, robots ruling the world and all that. If you could say yes or no to that happening, what would you say?
What do you mean by yes or no? What does that mean? Yes?
Surely robots already run the world. I mean, like 30% of tasks are done by computers.
Exactly. What a statistic. It's exciting, isn't it?
You're not scared?
No, it's the future, isn't it? So might as well just step into it.
I'm terrified.
Honestly, you don't need to be terrified.
Can you imagine walking into a bar and not being able to tell who's a robot and who's real?
I mean, I feel like that anyway in life, so... yeah.
This is your halfway warning, guys. That is 3 minutes to go. 180 seconds. Couldn't tell you how many milliseconds.
Time. You're wearing a watch, yet you still checked your phone.
You're right. Hands up, I must be a phone addict. And a laptop addict. And
I do that too, junkie, I always check so. My...
Oh, the full set. You wondering about me?
Yeah.
I feel like everyone should be asked this on a first date.
Why? So you know how distracted someone's going to be when you're trying to talk to them.
Okay, so I am addicted to my phone, but...
Here comes the excuse.
No, it's a generational thing. I mean, we grew up with our phones. I mean, they're like part of us. They're essential tools for our daily routines.
I could not agree more. You know, we are just so immersed in technology. People don't even realise it. We are constantly interacting with it. And it goes far beyond just phones.
Oh, yeah. I mean, GPS, search engines. My God, I'd be useless without all of that.
And take contactless payments, for example. That has completely revolutionised the whole social economics of how we buy things. For example, back a day, you would have to pull out your wallet, get some coins out, and pass it to the cashier, whereas I can now just go boop, and it's paid for like that. So I'd say these things here are definitely the quickest way to buy things at the moment. I actually...
Definitely.
I actually invented a smart band myself.
What?
What's that?
So, you know hair bands? You know how they've got that little metal connector bit? I've took a microchip with the same kind of contactless software and I've put it into it. So you can tie your hair up with it and just have it around your wrist. And with that, you could pay for something. And it's not as, you know, flashy as something like this. So it's inconspicuous.
How would you pay with your head?
Thank you.
Have you released any of them?
I made a few prototypes of the device. And then what I did was I reached out to a big tech company and sold the patent.
So he's got money.
Deal. Oh my God, are you loaded?
That's...
I'm signed up to NDAs, you know, so legally I can't.
Why would he?
Really, legally shouldn't have told you, I've just told you, you know, so
the
I can't.
The secret's safe with me.
Thank you.
Interesting.
1 minute to go, guys, minute. It's your final minute, and then we have to wrap it up. Moving on.
This has been an interesting date.
Oh, no, I haven't offended you in anything I've been talking about.
No, not at all. And I hope I haven't offended you.
I'm still here, aren't I?
I mean, not for much longer. We should make the last 60 seconds count.
Okay. I read somewhere that extroverts deal with these kind of situations a lot better than introverts. So would you say you're more extrovert or introvert?
Good question.
And you're not allowed to say both.
You're not allowed to say both.
In life, people either favour one side of the spectrum over the other.
I'm definitely an introvert. Just the idea of someone new sitting there and me having to talk to them makes a tiny bead of sweat drip down my armpit.
Oh my gosh, same.
Why would you say
this
that?
This cup under here is going in the bin when I get home.
I wonder what that smell was.
Why would really? You say that?
Of course not, I'm joking.
Oh, man. I am so bad at reading when people are making a joke or being serious. I really can't tell. I'm probably not the best match, are we?
And your time is up for that day. Gents, your date is awaiting.
Don't tell me you enjoyed that.
No, I did.
Me too. Stay in touch?
Yeah, if you want. My handle is @thebandcoder.
Unique handle. I'll hit you up.
Thank you. And bye, Misha.
Bye.
What was his name? Oh, that was cute, the little... Did he say his name? I can't remember what it was. The band coder. Into technology. Developed some hairband thingy that he sold for a lot of money. He could buy his own house. Jake, class is in session.
Hey.
Hey.
I'm a hugger. Should we hug?
Yeah, so am I. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, no. I would hate that so much.
I'm,
just sit Jake. Down.
Misha. I think I might have crinkled your shirt a bit, but...
no, I don't think you did. I've, Okay, so quick story. My grandmother buys me a birthday gift every year, and she likes to get me a shirt, and this is a vintage 2013.
No way!
Yeah. I'm a teacher and clearly too busy to buy my own clothes. So, do you have any birthday traditions?
Oh, I don't know if I can compete with that shirt. Grandma clearly knows her drip.
Hey, she's got good taste.
I actually do have a tradition. My granddad always buys me a jumper on my birthday.
I do love a jumper.
But he's colourblind, so... But instead of seeing the colours differently, he sees them all the same.
Mm. Oh.
It's called...
Trite anomaly.
This speed dating business is such like an interesting format.
Yeah, I think so. I actually don't get out too often. School's quite full on, so...
Summer holidays, though.
Exactly. Mm. You speed dated before? That's a verb.
Oh, you're going to mark me on this day, aren't you?
Nope.
No, I wouldn't do that to you. Of course not.
Oh. I haven't speed dated before.
Okay.
Just use apps and trying to meet people the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, me too. I don't normally do this type of thing, but I kind of thought, hey, why not enlist the help?
You're investing in your own happiness. I love that for you.
Yeah. Yeah, I love that for me too.
What is most important to you? In a relationship.
Yeah, I'm glad you added that last part. I'm not sure we're ready for politics just yet.
3 minutes to go. 3 minutes.
Well, maybe I'd be so bold to say I'm looking for love. What about you? Okay, was that too much?
No, I mean,
looks,
it's honest.
Brains and don't know yet.
Good to know.
Brains, I guess, what? What do you mean?
I want good conversation. Someone who can challenge me intellectually.
I think it's reasonable to expect stimulating conversation from someone you're spending time with. Now, as for the challenge part, so I gave the kids a pop quiz today. Fancy it?
Did you do this with all the ladies?
Oh, is it that obvious?
Yeah.
No, oh,
I'm
no.
I don't do it very
I'm gonna
often.
Fail.
Sure, if we have enough time.
Enough for a quick fire true or false round?
Mm-hmm, okay.
Okay, great. Question one. There is no word in the English language that rhymes with orange.
Yeah, that's true.
Orange. True.
Correct.
Yes.
okay, second question. The Caribbean island of Aruba is part of Portugal.
No fucking idea. False?
False. The island belongs to the Netherlands,
correct.
Right?
Woo!
Okay,
I did know that.
There are 14 bones in the human foot.
I think... Is there more? True? Wait, ooh, I meant false.
True.
Ooh, incorrect.
There's more.
There's actually 28 bones in each foot.
I clicked the wrong one.
Okay, 2 out of 3. It's very good.
Mm, it feels a bit mid to me.
It is.
It's above average, though.
I'll take that as a compliment.
You should.
1 minute to go. 1 minute warning.
So what else do you do with yourself, Jake, besides date randoms?
I like to read a lot. It's one of my favourite hobbies.
Air quotes, nice. I picked up a book in my time.
Favourite genre?
Oh, finishing with a toughie.
Yeah, could determine our entire future together.
No young pressure. Adult.
I think if I had to pick, I would choose young adult fiction.
Yeah? That's something I'm actually quite clued up on.
Oh, the kids, of course.
Yeah.
Do you feel like they're on the cusp of becoming, like, proper people?
That's a good question. I actually think they're quite clued up, far more than some of us adults. It's really interesting to see them sort of devour things, you know. I know that sounds super corny, but it's quite special to me.
I wish I had a teacher like you.
Thank you. That's sweet.
And that is time, ladies and gents.
Okay, well, it's over a bit too soon.
Oh, it was.
Listen, I'd love to be able to contact you.
Oh, yeah, what's your socials?
I'm not actually on socials. I don't even have a smartphone.
Oh, saving this news for the end of the date. Nice work.
Why don't you have a smartphone?
Old school.
I see what you did there.
I'll call you.
Nice to
meet
you.
Bye.
She seemed to really like the second guy a lot more than the first one. It probably has a lot to do with the interest that I put in, because the first guy clearly was technology, and I did not pick that for her. So the conversation kind of...
Hey.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I'm Misha.
I'm Ty.
You're not drinking?
No. No, bikes and alcohol. Don't go together.
True.
I like his nails.
Oh.
What?
Was sorry, she... it's a pandemic hangover.
You're an elbow bumper.
Oh. What the
I'm
fuck is
worker,
she doing?
So I've had to deal with a lot of COVID patients directly.
Well, that makes sense. Why you'd be careful. Seriously, though, you guys have been amazing. I don't know what we'd all do without the NHS.
So, Ty, what do you do with your days?
He's a motorcycle driver. I guess a biker. Whatever the fuck. That's it? That's all you gotta say?
Nice helmet.
Ask. Did he say that's inappropriate?
Go on, tell me. It's not gonna kill you. Unless you're part of some, like, mafia ring, in which case blink twice.
I'm just not into the whole interrogation thing.
Why are you here?
You're being serious.
I am.
Oh, shit, okay.
Not cool.
Clear as kind.
What? I feel like you're trying to manage my reactions.
Yeah, you do you.
What? You okay over there?
Yeah, I'm just checking some work emails.
This and that, right?
I don't like him.
Yeah.
And your time is up for that day, gents.
See ya.
Yeah, bye.
Why is he such a dick? Okay, well, who's next? Dash. Lads.
Hello.
Hey. I'm Misha.
I'm Bash, here for the interview. You been on holiday? You got that healthy beach glow.
Really? What's a holiday?
Oh, that's sad. I just got back from a stag do.
Nice. What did you get up to today?
Just played some father-side football with the boys. Yeah, pretty knackered.
I just went to the supermarket, did the weekly shop.
Do you still do that in person? I do it all online now, it's easy.
Yeah, of course, I've got to squeeze my fruits.
Why do you need to squeeze the fruits? What do you need to know about them? Their names? Hi, I'm Lenny, I'm a lemon.
That actually is a good name for a lemon, though.
Lenny, shut up, mate. Get him a gin and tonic.
Oh, lemons and G&Ts. That's ballsy.
Don't tell me you're a lime girl.
We're rivals. So, your name?
What about it?
Well, it's got to be a nickname, right?
Yeah, everyone needs a nickname.
So what's the story?
It's a long story.
Condense it?
No, it's a long story, leave it.
Oh, don't leave it. Guessing. At least give me some options.
Press.
You're an option.
So are you.
Yeah, fair.
I promise I won't judge, I'm just really curious.
Okay, so it all started with an awkward boner.
I beg your pardon?
Okay, look, I was 11 and I was on a school adventure trip and I got an awkward boner while I was waiting for my turn to go abseiling.
Okay.
And obviously everyone thought I was, you know...
Having a bash.
Yeah.
Having a
and
bash.
And you go by that nickname voluntarily.
Well, everyone calls me it, so I don't really have a choice, do I?
This is your halfway warning, guys. 3 minutes to go. I know, it flies, doesn't it?
So have you got any nicknames?
No, but my name is already sort of a nickname, apparently. It means Michael in Russian.
Michael. Mm. I knew someone called Michael once. He nicked my girlfriend in year six.
I'm sure she could choose for herself.
Can I call you Mike?
Yeah.
You got any real nicknames, then?
God, no one's ever asked me about nicknames before.
Well, I am honoured to be the first.
No, no nickname.
So come on, I ain't got all night.
No, no nicknames. We can't all be as fancy as you.
I am a proper gent, to be fair.
I think the Russian connection's cool enough, though.
I agree, Mike.
No.
Oh, come on, it's good. I'm doing you a favour. Everyone needs a nickname. Speaking of Eastern Europe, it's that stag do I mentioned, yeah? It was in Tallinn, in Estonia.
Tallinn, Estonia?
Yes. Yes, knowledge.
Stag capital of Europe, right?
So we had to see what all the hype was about. The second night was an absolute madness, okay? We were all in these morph suits, right? And the groom had to wear this mankini. By 5 p.m, he was absolutely battered. But after a little tactical vomit, we were ready to go to the club. It was the best night any of us had ever had. Drinks were flowing, there were back-to-back bangers on the playlist, all the lads, they were all together.
That's great.
Then, there's a little bump in the road. This bird takes a liking to the groom. He wants to go back to his room.
No freaking way.
Oh my God.
Don't worry. Big bad Bash was there to intercept the potential disaster.
It's not encouraging for a happily married life, is it?
Yeah. We all had a big old heart-to-heart with him the morning after about it. That's all we can do as his mates, you know? In my mind, cheating is absolutely unacceptable. And his wife-to-be, she deserves better.
Oh, this is commendable on your part.
I have to have some principles, don't I?
We've got 1 minute to go, guys. Just 1 minute. So we'll be wrapping up very soon.
Seems like we might be drawing to a close.
You sick on me already?
Definitely. You seen anyone you like, though?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely, yeah. What about you?
You didn't answer me properly.
What more do you want from me?
I don't know, some more detail? Names, maybe?
Nope. No names necessary.
Why would you...
No one special.
Until you met me.
Yeah, all right.
See, I reckon you lucked out, you know.
And why is that?
Because there are some proper mingers in here tonight.
Stop it.
What's
a minger?
Look at the state of those two over there. Like, he literally looks like a walking turnip.
I feel bad for agreeing with you.
But you do agree.
No comment.
Love to hear it.
Present company excluded, of course.
Yeah, it bloody better do.
And your time is up for that day, gents. You'll be moving along to your next table.
That wasn't so bad, was it?
It wasn't. What's your socials?
Yes, we should stay in touch. It's at Big Bash 123.
Oh, you need a better handle.
Yeah.
You love it.
Ugh.
See you in my DMs, babe.
Bye.
There's no way matching.
Not really.
See that.
Okay, so he's a fuckboy. End of the night. Okay, wait, if I hit S. Oh, there's a whole bunch of... What is this? Okay, wait. Who did we meet? We met Lucas. Okay. Ty sucks. Okay, get out of here. I don't know what this is. This is like... spoilers.
No way. What are the chances? For the podcast, the Miserable Millennial Book Club.
Yeah.
So, are you here for this speed dating thing?
Oh, I'm just waiting for my mate to finish, yeah. You?
No, I prefer to do things solo.
Reading a bar seems like a new one.
Well, considering all the coffee shops are shut, I don't really have a choice.
I'm the same, actually. I like taking myself out for a meal or a spa day or a weekend away.
Or a spa weekend away.
Mate, stop.
I'm Hazel, by the way.
Misha.
My absolute favourite thing to do solo, which I totally recommend, is go to the cinema. Hmm. You can lean back, switch your phone off for a few hours and just absorb the story.
Seems like a great mode of self-care.
I just love my films, mate. Like, if you were to go, what would you watch?
Alone.
Alone? On a date? Whatever.
God, I don't ever go comedy. To the cinema alone.
All right, well, what genre would you pick?
I love comedy films.
Oh, rom-com's my favourite.
Yeah, but other types too, like buddy cop comedies and slapstick comedies.
Spoofs, comedy horrors, gross-out comedies. Mm. I mean, the world needs all the laughter it can get these days.
Yeah, yep. And laughing makes you live longer too.
Well, let me know if you find someone funny then.
I will.
So, how was the speed dating?
It was fun. Unpredictable, but yeah, fun.
Did you meet anyone sexy?
Is that word still in circulation?
Probably not, maybe, but no. I think I might bring it back. Why not?
No one's really caught my eye. I don't think it's the speed dating. I think it's just...
for men?
Maybe. Or me.
I doubt it.
I appreciate that. Even though you've only just met me.
I am an extremely good judge of character.
I'll hold you to that.
You should.
Yeah.
This is your 3-minute warning, guys. 3 minutes to go.
That poor horse voice must be ruined.
Yeah, it's the last date of the night, so I'll be off to meet Ryan soon.
In that case, let's get you a drink for the road. It's 2-for-1 until the event ends, so that gives you about 2.5 minutes, as of now.
Oh, hell's bells, let's do it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll order. A couple of G&Ts, they'll be quick, won't they?
Oh, I think we could do better with what little time we've got.
Shots?
Shots.
Let's do it. Excuse me? What is it? Salt, lemon first?
Oh, I don't know.
No.
Oh, no. Oh, no, not live either. So, Hazel, I know what you do for fun, but what do you do for work?
Oh, no. See, this is why I didn't lead with this. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I do HR. Mm. Just your very basic, boring 9-to-5.
Explains why you're such a people person, though.
Mm-hmm. Got 1 minute to go, guys. Just 1 minute.
Already?
You know what I'm miffed about? How come Ryan got an extra date to me?
Yeah.
Well... we can call this a speed date if you want.
I agree.
Didn't think that was an option.
It is.
Why not? I mean, we are abiding by time restrictions and everything.
Annoyingly. I wish we had longer. Do you want to keep in touch and maybe we can hang out sometime? As much as I love doing things solo, I would really love a partner in crime.
Now yes.
Someone take your pics of social media and all that.
Yeah, it's more of a PA role, really.
She's so cute.
I'd love to.
And that is time, everyone. Hopefully see you at the next one.
Well, you don't want to keep Ryan waiting. At HazelX1. You can hit me up there.
Got it. Mm-hmm. Bye, Hazel.
Yeah. See you soon, hopefully.
Yeah.
Enjoy that book.
Bye.
Come on, spill the beans. How do they go?
Okay. Jake was really lovely. He was a teacher. He had some nice shirts.
So he's a nice guy.
He was a really good nice guy. He's so sweet.
Could you see there being a second date?
Yeah, I could.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That sounds lovely.
Bash. Well, firstly, he's called Bash, which tells you everything you need to know. Do you know what? He was really charming. He had really great banter.
Yeah,
in a good way, yeah.
In a really good way. He had a slightly funny haircut, but we'll let him.
So, do you think there could be another date?
Yeah, I could see that happening.
Interesting.
Yeah. Okay, good.
So that was Lucas. He was a coder. He was super intelligent. I didn't understand half of what he said, but he was really lovely.
Okay, so maybe you might see him again?
Yeah, that's definitely a possibility.
Okay, nice.
Oh my gosh, there was Hazel.
Okay.
Who I met at the bar by accident. We were reading exactly the same book. We had the same interests. She was really fun. She wasn't even meant to be there.
So she hadn't signed up for it?
No, she was just in the bar.
Okay, so she sounds like it went well.
It went really surprisingly well.
Okay, nice. I'm liking Hazel.
Hazel could maybe progress to date too.
You think so?
I think so.
Okay.
So Ty came in his motorcycle leathers, holding his helmet. He is what you would call a bad boy.
He sounds like it was a little bit different.
Yeah, I don't think we exactly gelled. I think we're from slightly different worlds.
I feel like you're doing all right without him.
I think so. I'm going to keep my good girl image for a bit longer.
Yeah, you hang on to that image as long as you can. It won't last long, but you know. So, Misha, what's gonna happen next?
I have a few options.
Well, remember what we said? You need to make the first move. Send them a message.
Mm. Okay.
Pinky swear.
Pinky swear.
Okay.
So what about you? Tell me about your speed dating.
Okay. Oh, what is this? Select your second dates. Jake, Big Bash. Okay, first of all, Hazel, absolutely. Recovering book addict. Don't cling to a mistake. Have the courage to be disliked. Yeah, she's so cute. Okay. Jake is the teacher. Oh, I only get two! Can I look at all of them? Let's look at this guy's stuff. 4 posts. 4,000 followers. So much cooler online here. Yeah. Okay. Let's look at Bash. Live life to the full. 300 followers. Yeah, he's a partier. He likes to drink. Just young and dumb. And then Jake. Jake, Mr. Not Online. Let's do him as well. Okay, Hazel. Where do you stand?
Hey!
Hey, you!
I've read that one too. Any good?
She dies at the end.
No. Why would you say that?
Yeah,
she doesn't.
That's not cool.
You've been here long?
Yes, actually. But I'm always painfully early. It's kind of my thing. What about you? What's your time keeping like?
Oh, straight in with the analytics.
I've been staring at spreadsheets all day.
On time.
Gathering data has become my second nature.
I'm always freakishly on time. I think it's a disease.
Right, okay, so I can say this now because we're working out with the same person.
Right.
I hate people who are late.
Me too, it's so rude.
There's no excuse for it.
Like 5 minutes is fine, but anything else, I'm like...
Now see, I'm like, set off earlier.
Bit traffic? Well,
leave yourself in case of traffic a bit more time.
Compliment her outfit.
Oddball you are.
No messing about.
I love your outfit.
Oh, thanks. It was, it was a gift.
Dungarees. You cannot go wrong with dungarees.
I know.
Just chuck them on. Life uniform, right?
Absolutely. Do you own a lot of dungarees?
I have like 10 pairs of dungarees.
I have about 3 and I think that's enough.
Yeah, okay.
I think you've taken the biscuit there.
I'm sorry.
Time.
Should we get a drink?
Yes, definitely. What do you fancy?
Maybe a cosmopolitan.
Ooh, I haven't had one in ages.
Okay.
Excuse me.
James.
Can I get 2 cosmopolitans, please?
Mm-hmm.
negative eye contact.
Don't like mint.
Don't like mint. I don't like mint at all.
Mm. I like that. Okay, this might sound silly.
I love silly.
Great. My uncle made up this holiday game called Where Do You Stand? So, like, one person brings up a topic and then it leads to, like, a debate or a discussion or an argument.
Okay, can I go first?
Be my guest.
Right, let me think. Right. Where do you stand on one-night stands?
Yeah, never played that one with the family before.
Yeah. Big questions are better, this game.
You've played it before? Uncle Jim said he made it up.
Uncle Jim lied.
Rude. I think as long as they're done safely, like, within every sense of the word, I mean, what's the harm?
Yeah, exactly. Like, I think there's an experience behind each one. From, like, the moment you spot someone you fancy to
the walk of shame afterwards.
Yeah, see, I prefer stride of pride.
There you go. That's good.
Okay, my turn. What topic do I want your opinion on?
Tattoos.
Oh, too well, because your brain might explode.
Tattoos. Where'd you stand?
Okay, I haven't got any personally, but I've also nothing against them. What about you?
Nada. I am a blank canvas as of now. Would you get any?
No.
Even if something meant a lot to you?
Yeah, I think especially if it means something to me. Like, because if you've got something on your body and you can see it every day, doesn't it sort of lose its significance? Like, if I was going to get one, I'd get something really cool just so I could look at it.
That's an interesting view.
Right.
Okay, my turn. Okay. Peace and war. Where do you stand?
Oh,
what
that's a big
that
one.
What does that mean?
Are you going to draw any, like, big conclusions from my answer here?
Yeah. Not quite possibly, I will, yeah.
Great, okay.
That's so vague. What does this mean? Peace.
Peace, obviously.
Why, obviously?
Well, why do I support senseless killings for the whims of politicians?
Military conflict's never going away. It's a sad fact of life, but I think accepting it and making sure it's done in the right context is the only way forward.
Which would be...
Well, we're not going to get into that now.
That's interesting.
Besides, the world needs pacifists to make sure we're not starting wars over anything and everything.
She's pro-war? That's weird.
Mm. What are you going to ask? What are you dying to hear my
exercise.
Opinion?
Yes.
Exercise? Where do you stand?
I think I'm like most people. I have bursts of gym motivation every now and again.
How long do those bursts last?
Yeah, usually a week.
I do not believe that. I mean, come on, look at you.
It's a good metabolism. I'm getting away with it for now.
Yeah.
Morning or evening?
For exercise or just in general?
Just in general.
Okay. It's pretty straightforward.
But also, evening. You think the complexity comes in your reasoning.
Mm. I'm a night owl.
And I'm a morning person. Mm. We're completely compatible.
How does that work?
Because we complement each other.
Yeah, there you go.
It's like yin and yang.
Okay.
It's like if we were together in the dark ages, one of us would be there to hunt in the morning and one of us would be there to watch the fire at night.
Aww. So I'll make the dinner and you get us coffee.
That sounds like a very good deal to me.
That's cute.
I feel like I can be quite open with you. Do you want to tell the truth? Or is that ridiculous?
No, I like it. But you go first.
Okay.
On the count of three. One, two, three.
I'm addicted to cigarettes.
What?
You're a smoker.
It started last year when I was going through a really stressful period of my life.
COVID related?
Yeah. But in my defence, I'm weaning myself off them and my next resolution for the new year is to give them up completely. Okay. Your turn.
Oh, no, I'm still thinking of one.
Okay, here we go.
Three, never
two,
dated a woman.
One.
I've never been in love.
Oh, I mean, clicked the wrong one.
Yeah. Platonic love, yeah. Lust, yeah, but actual real love? Like really falling for someone? No. Nothing mutual anyway.
Hmm. Oh, that's something to look forward to. The first time is always intoxicating.
Hmm. You speak from experience.
Oh, yeah. It's just like everything's bubbling up inside you and you can't stop it. But not that you want to stop it. Everything's just better. Every morning, every night, even a dead-end job in HR is a joy when you're sailing through life in love.
Yeah.
But it didn't last forever.
No. It was out of my control, but...
It's only ever going to last forever once,
I'm ready to
so...
get back to it.
You've really
fall in love as many times as you can.
Cheers, cheers.
Oh, that was cute. She's took the differences really well, too. I like that they can complement each other like that. You don't have to agree on everything. Her being pro-war over peace is...
I'll let Uncle Jim know the game was a success. Please do.
A little weird, but...
Oh, thanks. Misha, I don't normally ask this, but would you be all right to cover my part?
It's weird.
I'm just in a really hard spot financially. The
60
whole thing.
Bucks.
If you won't mind.
Yeah, sure.
It would really help me. You know what? If you're in a hard spot, I'm happy to help.
Oh, thank you so much. I can't tell you how grateful I am.
Is it rent day or something?
Yeah. Yeah, that and I've had to take some unexpected time off work recently, so...
Oh, why?
Well, I hope you get back to the office soon.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
She lose her job? Am I ever going to find out the answers?
It's been about to. I've got to go in a minute, but I've got to wait for my taxi.
Well, I'll just wait with you.
Oh, yeah. What's that?
Shit. Nothing. Look, I'd really love to walk you home, but I've just got to get back myself.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, no, it's fine. Oh. Text me when you're home, will you?
Yeah,
sure. All right, I'll see you soon.
Suspicious. This is like the 5 dates. I had all these suspicions, but none of it ever came to light. So I don't know. Is anything going to come to light for this? Like, she's being really weird.
Hey.
Hey.
How are you?
The hugger.
Yeah, good. Please, have a seat.
It's very formal.
Yeah, I thought I'd try and change up a bit.
Interview with me.
Yes. So, you like the job of...
I would. You waited.
I did. The waiter advised that I should wait for you to open the bottle.
Mm, that is good advice.
I thought so.
How was your weekend?
Yeah, my weekend was good. I went to see my sister. Her kids are super into tractors, so let's just say got very muddy.
This is too wholesome. Like, there's got to be a catch somewhere.
Not that I'm aware of.
I'm not sure of it yet. Do you get, like, the grandchildren spiel when you go home? Every time I go home, I get it.
Yeah, so I'm very lucky. I have three siblings, and they've all got kids, so I'm off the hook for now.
Good siblings. Do you play with your nieces and nephews?
Yeah, only when they're good.
Have I been good? That's, like, a random way of me saying, like, do you want some game time?
Okay. Okay, quizmaster at your service.
Okay, great idea. Why don't we do one that's, like, about us, like, our lives?
Okay, go on.
Okay, so to make it easier, you have to pose answers. So whoever is the quizzer has to pose a question and give 3 possible answers.
Okay. Okay, I'll go
first.
Yeah?
Okay.
Question 1. What is your favourite type of day? Is it active? Is it relaxed? Or a bit both? One where, like, you feel super amazing by the end of it.
A bit of both.
Okay, I've got an answer.
Okay, I am going to say... relax.
Not quite. I think I like to mix it up, like a hike in the day and like maybe a board game in the night, because like balance is key.
I'm here for the board game side of things. I'm serious. Okay. There's nothing better than...
Sex and Ladders.
Snakes and Ladders.
Right.
Definitely indoors, board game when it's raining, yeah. Wet play.
Excuse me?
Why'd you say that?
That's what we call it at school.
Yeah.
Wet play for the kids.
Sure.
Why?
Okay, my turn. Okay. What is your biggest turn on? Kisses, cuddles, or words? You thinking of it?
Yeah, I think I've got something.
Channeling your thoughts telepathically.
Kisses, cuddles.
I'm gonna go with kisses.
Kisses? Sure?
Yeah.
Oh, so close. I like kisses. I do, but I'm more cuddles.
Oh, that's sweet.
I know. I thought so. Okay, I got another one. Question 3. What do you value most in a partner? Kindness, bravery, or honesty?
It's a tough one. Can I choose all 3?
No, you have to prioritize.
Kindness, bravery, or honesty? Honesty.
Okay, I've got my answer.
I mean, personally speaking, I hope the quality that you value most in a partner is kindness.
honesty. Everything else is just noise.
Okay. Is honesty being kind?
Question four.
Okay, question four. What is key to your heart? Is it wine? Is it food? Or is it conversation?
Oh, this one's easy.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with conversation.
Okay, spoke too soon. Conversation.
Bingo. Hang on. Did you say that because I talk a lot? Do you think I talk a lot?
No. I'm actually more of a foodie myself. So.
I'm just kidding.
Okay.
Why? Oh my god. I don't like this.
So, have you ever cooked dinner for anyone on a date before?
It's kind of my signature move.
What's your star dish?
My star dish is risotto with some parmesan, a bit of truffle oil.
Speechless.
Yeah, wait till you try it.
So, if you like cooking, have you ever tried food play?
Is this a follow-up question? No, I haven't. What about you?
No, that's gross.
This wine is delicious.
Not so saucy.
Deflecting, okay. Yeah, it's one of my favourites.
Food and sex. I'm thinking they're two things that should be separate. Sounds messy.
I'm 100% happy to never talk about this again.
We could be vanilla together.
Who are you calling vanilla?
I mean you, but like Haagen-Dazs vanilla.
Why are you saying these things?
So would you say you're a romantic?
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you believe in like the one?
Yeah, I do. I do believe in the one. I'd like to think that there's someone out there waiting for us. That is just right. I don't know. Call me soppy, but I'm a bit of a wide-eyed optimist.
I do believe in the one. I think Plato might have been onto something. That we're all just wandering around searching for other halves, looking to complete ourselves.
Yeah, and not that we're half a person, but I definitely believe that there's someone out there that fits with us perfectly.
Exactly. It's not that we're lacking anything, it's just that they add to us in a way.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't think it happens overnight, but there's definitely one person out there for you. And you may start to get to know them and you spend some more time with them. Next thing you know, you want to spend the rest of your life together.
More like a slow burn then.
Exactly that.
It's whiny.
That's what they call me.
Call them whiny.
It's been so lovely.
Yeah, it really has.
Oh my god.
Listen, thank you for coming on a second date with me.
Let's split it.
Likewise.
Yeah, really appreciate it.
Let's split it.
No, I can get it.
Your offer is more than enough and I would like to pay my way.
Okay, I won't fight you on it.
Shall we?
Yeah, let's. Off to you.
Such a gent.
I do try it.
They're kind of cute. I don't know. I really don't know about either of them at this point, honestly. Let's check this thing here. Okay. I don't know what I'm supposed to be checking from here. Who is the other one? Hazel. Okay, what did they think of you? She thinks we're confident, kind, funny, and spontaneous. Jake thinks we're 80% confident. Kind, secure. Okay.
Anyway.
Yeah.
I've been wanting to ask you something.
What?
Very important.
Oh, gosh.
You ready?
No.
Well, I'm going to ask you either way if you're ready or not.
Go.
Who is getting the call for the third date?
Can we date the friend? Like, he's so cute.
Do it now.
to do it now. Ugh. Okay. Who do we go on a third date with? Oh my god, I don't know. Let me look at this again. Security. And kindness. Oh. I guess. I don't know. It could be fine with either of them, really. Maybe Hazel. I think. Yeah, let's do Hazel.
Yeah. I'm good, thanks, you? Yeah, of course you are. Look, I was just wondering if you wanted to hang out again. I know this really lovely place. Oh my god, amazing, yeah. That's great. I will text you the details. Okay, bye.
Oh my god.
Did it.
You excited?
Yeah, maybe.
A little bit. How excited?
Really excited.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I feel like we're not gonna find out.
Hello?
Why she's being all mysterious.
Oh my god, thank you.
Right.
Do you bring reading material on all your dates or just
only the ones I like? And this one is my latest obsession.
I am honoured.
Oh, sorry. My sister, Megan, she's on a date tonight and she's absolutely breaking it. Do you mind if I just give her a call?
Go for it.
Hey, babe, you okay? You almost there? Yeah, I'm with her now. No, don't apologise. She doesn't mind. No, honestly, she doesn't mind. All right, would you feel better if I put you on speakerphone? Okay. Misha, meet Megan.
Hi, Megan.
You're right, Misha. Sorry I'm stealing hairs from you.
No, it's fine.
I'm nearly at the bar. Sweating like a glass blower's arse.
Are you quite an anxious person?
Not usually. Right, hairs?
Yeah, not at all.
I'm meeting them off a dating app, which I never do. Swipe, yes. Flirt, yes. Write unsolicited dick pics, sometimes. Meet in person? Absolutely bloody not.
Well, I mean, if you're meeting them in a public place, then you can just bail if you feel uncomfortable.
Okay, thanks, Misha.
I said that.
Sorry, Hiz. Just Misha sounds more legit than you. Okay, I'm going in. Reckon you could stay in my ears?
How would we do that?
My hair covers my wireless earphones. They won't notice.
This is some secret agent shit.
I got you, baby girl. Okay, so what's on your mind?
What do I do if they don't look like the pictures? Like a mahoosive catfish?
I'm guessing you haven't video called or anything?
No, or should I have?
Well, it might have been a good screening test, but it's a bit late now.
Posting accurate photos is such a shit move and I would walk straight out.
You don't know why the person felt the need to do that.
They could be really insecure.
Megan, it's not your problem if they're insecure. It shows a lot of disrespect for you and your time.
Actually, yeah, you're right, Misha. Damn right it does.
I think that's a bit harsh.
Positive thinking, though. They will look as good as their pics.
Oh my god, it's them. I'm walking over. Hey, you! Oh my goodness, I am so glad you look like your pictures.
Oh, thanks, you too. Great to meet you, Megan.
First crisis avoided.
Yeah.
Why are we whispering? They can't hear us.
That's true, actually.
Shall we get some drinks?
Oh, sure, yeah. This place does the best espresso martinis. I'll get us a couple.
Did they just order for you, Megan? No, it's a bit of a red flag for me, that.
Yeah. Espresso martinis sound good?
Espresso martinis.
I disagree.
Don't even like those. They give you the shit.
Oh.
Give them the benefit of the doubt.
What?
They might have seen she was nervous and wanted to help.
But by forcing her to drink something she doesn't want to.
They want her to have fun and feel like she's taken care of, you know. Go with the flow.
You better be right.
Oh, man. This is not going well.
I know this isn't the cool thing to say.
Nah, cool schmool.
Yeah, I've been looking forward to this all day. It probably got me through work and that.
Oh, that's nice, right?
Meeting me. Your job must be shit.
I actually love it, but it's just that I never matched girls like you, so, yeah.
Oh, they sound pretty genuine to me. I know how they feel.
Very smooth.
Like what I did there? Sorry, Megan. Show some appreciation. They'll like that.
Well, that's just made my day.
We'll call it even then. So, Megan, what do you do for fun?
Yeah, you know, I never know what counts as a hobby. Like, I scroll TikTok before bed every night. Does that count? I cook every day, but that's because I'd die otherwise.
Oh, poor thing, she's rambling.
She's got to improve the chat.
What, like, change the topic to something more interesting?
No, small talk's good at this stage, you know. Gotta get the flow going.
Acupuncture. I just did a course in it. There's a hobby of mine.
Well, then how can you progress the hobby chat?
I find acupuncture terrifying. Needles of all girths are a hard pass for me.
Ask about a hobby.
I see.
Return the interest, ask about their hobbies.
You sure?
A well-balanced two-way conversation is essential.
You know what? You tell me about your hobbies.
Yeah, sure. I'd say my main passion is golf. I'm out on the green every chance I get. Evenings, weekends.
You have all your own golf sticks and everything.
Golf clubs.
I just got a new set, actually. I really need to work on my chipping, so I paid a bit extra on a pro-level pitching wedge. And a sand wedge, for that matter. They're different, you see.
Uh-huh.
Oh, no. And that's why she should have led the talking.
They're as bad as each other.
Aye.
So, if you know the espresso, martinis here so well, is it your regular date spot?
Oh, God, no. I barely ever go on app dates. How about you?
Me,
What do people like to hear you?
Depends. Cook up both ways.
Guys, please.
Who are you talking to?
Troops.
No one didn't say anything.
Oh, you need to save her.
Be honest, Megan. Don't get off on the wrong foot by lying.
Look, I'll be honest. I barely date at the best of times, let alone from apps. They scare me that I won't match up to my profile.
Well, Megan, you more than match up to me, and I feel honoured you took a punt on meeting me.
Do they actually?
Well, for sure. App dating feels like one big competition, so it's nice to feel unique.
2 seconds, Megan, I'm just going to pop to the loo.
Take your time. Okay, guys, I'm alone for a sec.
How do you feel, baby girl?
Quite fancy them.
Get in, Megan.
Yes.
What would you like to know next?
I actually think I got it from here.
Love that from you. We'll debrief later tonight.
For sure. Thank you so much, guys. Oh, they're coming back. Gotta go. Bye.
I know she thanked us both, but it was mainly you.
I just went with my gut.
Well, your gut is very impressive.
That sounded better in your head, didn't it?
Completely.
Yeah. Well, in all that excitement, we forgot to order any food.
And drinks. Let's get to it.
Yes!
Why is there nobody up here?
Hello?
Mama,
call later.
Can I want to see if anything changed. Nothing changed. What is the point of the screen?
I've got to say, you seem like a great friend to Megan more than anything else.
Well, if nothing else, I'm loyal to a fault.
What do you mean?
You know, I had to dash at the end of our last date.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I just assumed you had to run off to watch something on the telly.
Let me just show you.
Why would you assume that?
Is that a tag?
Just let me explain.
What, you're fresh out of prison?
No, I've not been to prison. I'm on bail pending trial.
For?
ABH.
What's that?
I was out with Megan and then some guy groped her, so I walloped him one. Smashed him in the face, cracked his nose, blood everywhere, he got sent to hospital.
That's nothing to be proud of.
I'm not proud of it.
Why would you?
But I would do it again in a heartbeat to protect people that I love. It does mean I still have to be in by 10 tonight.
Is this your first brush with the law? Or?
I mean, I did some graffiti as a kid, but it's not like I go looking for that stuff. It just...
It finds you?
Misha, I want you to know this is not the person that I am.
Can't help the situation. I'm going to say no problem.
I've spent enough time with you to know that you're not a bad person.
I don't know.
We just need to keep you out of trouble.
That won't be hard with someone like you. I was suspended from work because of the incident.
I knew something weird.
I was supposed to go back last week, but my perspective's just changed. I realised that life can just change in the blink of an eye, so why would I want to go back to that rat race?
You really don't like your job, do you?
No. But sadly, I've got bills to pay.
Yeah.
What would you do in my shoes?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how disgruntled are you?
I'm a strong 15.
Change your fix. What does that mean? Fix.
Look, these past 2 years have shown us that nothing's certain. London is unforgiving and you should cling on to stability while you've got it. But that doesn't mean you've got to endure it. I mean, there are things you can do, ways you can help yourself.
Do you not think I've tried that? I just feel so trapped.
You're not actually living in a prison. You can talk to your bosses.
Not yet.
There's always room for compromise.
Make lemonade out of lemons.
Hmm. Exactly, it's the lowest risk.
Sounds like you're a fixer, not a changer when it comes to problems.
I'd rather face things than run away from them.
Mm. Okay. So not changing and facing our problems.
Not changing. I don't know how I feel about that date.
I'm growing a massive food, baby.
I've got one more mouthful of tiramisu here if you want to help me out.
Yeah, go on then.
You have a very resilient nature.
That would have been key defense to my judge.
Curfew alarm?
Yep. It was great seeing you again. I just want to know what your nature thinks about us.
Oh, that was very slick.
So slick.
I don't know.
I really like you, Hazel. You're beautiful and genuine and trustworthy. And I know you'll always have my back.
I really like you too, Misha. I really want to just run away and kiss you, but I've got to go.
Well, let's run together.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Misha and Hazel celebrated her tag coming off the spontaneous weekend by the coast. They are planning many more to come. Okay. At the end of the game. Okay. What do I feel about that? I don't know. Honestly, I like five dates a lot more than this game so far based on one playthrough. I think I should have chose Jake instead of Hazel. I don't really see her in... Whoa, we could have went with Derek? That was not an option. Tony. Okay, so this is what, if we play as the guy? Azalea? I don't know how to say that. Look at her! Brandy. Kathleen. Who else is in here? Interesting. How do you get the host? Free to try other events. Huh. I don't know. I guess... Yeah, I really like the first game. A lot better than this one. This one didn't have as many choices, like, to make. I feel like the first one, you had a lot more things to say to people. I could be wrong. I could be remembering wrong. But yeah, so this was 10 dates. I think I chose wrong. Well, okay. Anyway. That was 10 dates, and we ended up with Hazel, and I'm not sure how I feel about that.